So this will be our final video in the Time Value of Money series. And in this video, we're going to be talking about the third type of annuity, which is a deferred annuity. Remember, a deferred annuity incorporates both lump sum amounts as well as annuity amounts. So therefore, we call it a deferred annuity. So let's look at an example. So assume a contract involving payments of different amounts each year for a three-year period. And then we're also going to add an annuity at the end of that. But the first thing we have to do is to discount each one of these back to the present, because we're looking for the present value of this deferred annuity. And this, in the first part of this, is the lump sum amounts. We have to treat each one of these as single lump sums because they're not the same amount. Therefore, they're not an annuity. These are each single lump sums. So for example, in period one, we made a payment of $1,000, or we're receiving a payment of $1,000. Either way, what we need to find out is, what would I need to invest today, or at the beginning, to be able to have $1,000 at the end of year one? The second payment is $2,000. What would I have to invest today to have $2,000 at the end of the second year? The third payment is $3,000. What would I have to invest today to have $3,000 at the end of 3 years? So we've got to look into our present value factor tables. And when you do that at 8%, you find your factors. For year one is 0.9259 or 0.926, whatever your table might be, it depends on the rounding. Second year would be 0.8573, and year three would be 0.79388. You multiply that times the lump sums for each period, and you find the present value of these three lump sums to be $5,022. Now, up to this point, this is simply just three different lump sums. It's not really a deferred annuity. However, if we tack on individual equal payments to that, as in this timeline here, you see years 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 are all $1,000 payments. That makes the end of this income stream or payment stream an annuity. Therefore, we have a deferred annuity because the first several payments are lump sum amounts, they are differing amounts, and the ending payments are equal amounts, which means there's a portion of this that's an annuity. Well, we found the present value of the first three lump sums to be $5,022. Now we've got to find the present value of the annuity portion. Well, to do that, we would need to go into our present value of an ordinary annuity tables, because as we see in the second bullet up here, that these are paid at the end of each year, so that makes this an ordinary annuity. So if we go to our ordinary annuity tables, at 8%, we're looking for 5 periods, so years 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So at 8% in 5 periods, we find the factor to be 3.99271, or thereabouts, again, depending on what table you're using. So if we take that factor and multiply it times our $1,000, we find that the present value at the end of the third year, the beginning of the fourth year, for this stream of annuity payments is $3,993. Well, let's look at that in a timeline. So here we have our present value of our annuity stream at the end of the third period, or the beginning of the fourth period, that's the same time period, is $3,993. But we don't want to know what that annuity is valued at the end of the third year. We want to know what it's valued at today. So in other words, what would I have to invest today to be able to start withdrawing, or what would I have to accrue to be able to pay $1,000 a period at the beginning of the fourth period, or starting in year four, making the payment at the end of year four, end of year five, end of year six, etc. What would I need that amount to be? So now that we found that lump sum, what it's valued at the end of the third period, we can now discount that amount back to today as a lump sum. So we would go into our present value of lump sum tables, look for 3 periods at an interest rate of 8%, discounting that $3,993 back to today, and we find that we would need to invest or deposit $3,170 today at 8% to be able to have $3,993 at the end of the third period. Now that still doesn't really answer the question. We need to know, what is the present value of this deferred annuity? Well, that includes the annuity portion and the three lump sums that we had in years 1, 2, and 3, which we found the present value of those to be $5,022. If we add the two numbers together, the 5,022 and the 3,170, we find that the total present value of this deferred annuity to be $8,192. So now I'd like for you to try one. Here we have Del Monte will receive the following payments at the end of the next 3 years, $2,000, $3,500, and $4,500. Then, from the end of the fourth through the end of the 10th year, he will receive an annuity of $5,000 per year. At a discount rate of 9%, what is the present value of all future benefits? So, using whatever tables you have, figure out what the net present value of all this deferred annuity will be. We know it's a deferred annuity because there are lump sum portions and there's actually an annuity portion. So press pause on your player now, figure out the answer to this question, then we'll come back and look at it together. Okay, so the first thing you had to do was find the present value of the first three lump sums. So going into your present value tables, you will get the present value factor of each one of these as you go down the line in your present value factor table at 9%. Multiplying those factors times the lump sums, we find that the present value of the lump sum amounts in years 1, 2, and 3 to be $8,255. The second step is to find the present value of the annuity portion. Well, the value of the annuity at the beginning of the fourth year would be 9% at 7 periods, using your present value of an ordinary annuity tables, because the problem tells us that the payments are made at the end of each year. That makes this an ordinary annuity. So we take the payment amount of $5,000, multiply that times the factor that we find in our tables, 5.033 should have been approximately the number you found, and multiplying those through, we get $25,165. This does not answer the question. This simply gives me the amount of the annuity at the end of the third year or the beginning of the fourth year. I want to know what the total net benefit or present value of all this cash flows are at the beginning here. Okay, so the value at the beginning, we would need to now discount this $25,165 back to today. Well, that's over 3 periods at 9%. So if you go to your present value of lump sum tables, we find that factor to be 0.772 or thereabouts. Multiplying that through, you get $19,427.38. Now that we know the present value of the annuity, the deferred annuity portion, we can add that amount back to the present value of the first three lump sum payments that we found to be $8,225. And we get a total net present value of the deferred annuity and the three lump sum payments of $27,682.38.